In this video, we cover the steps to set up and configure VTL on a Data Domain 3300 system. Using a browser, use the system IP address to connect to the DD3300 and log in. On the left-hand side pane, go to Administration and then Licenses. Here, check for the VTL license under Feature Licenses. Go to Hardware and then Fiber Channel. Here, check that ports and endpoints are visible with link status as online. Also, verify that the zoned initiators are visible under Initiators. Next, go to Protocols and then the DDVTL page. Check that the DDVTL service is running and is licensed. After that, go to the DD Virtual Tape Libraries, DDVTL Service, and then Libraries. Now, to create a new library, from the More Tasks menu, choose Create. Here, type the name you want to use for the library and enter the appropriate number of drives. Use the Drive Model drop-down menu to see the supported drives. In this case, we kept the default value. If you leave the value for number of slots as blank, the default value of 20 will be used. If you leave the number of caps blank, the default value of 0 will be used. And then, select the appropriate changer model names from the drop-down menu. At this point, the newly created library will be visible under Libraries. Based on the settings we used, it shows 10 drives, 20 slots, and 0 caps. Changer and drives can be seen under the newly created library. Go to Access Groups, which is listed below DD Virtual Tape Libraries, and then Groups. Tape Server is a default group present on the system. To create a new group, choose Create from the More Tasks drop-down menu. Enter a group name, and then select one or more initiators from the listed initiators. In this case, Initiator 1 is selected. Then click Next. To add devices, click the plus sign seen in the top right. Select the appropriate library from the drop-down. Then, from the list of available devices, select the devices to be added to this group. In this case, all devices were selected. Leave the value of start address under LUN as blank, and let the system assign the LUN numbers. Click Next. For primary endpoints, select All, which is the default value, and click Next. For secondary endpoints, select All, which is also the default value, and click Finish. At this point, verify all the values are entered properly, and click Next. Again, verify the values for the displayed summary for this access group, and click Finish. The new access group will be listed under Groups, and all the devices can be seen in the group with the system-assigned LUN numbers. Go to Pools, which is the last item in the left menu of the DDVTL page. Default is a default pool. To create a new pool, from the More Tasks drop-down menu under Pool, choose Create. In the dialog box, enter a valid pool name and click Finish. The pool will then get listed under Pools in the left side menu. Now, to create tapes inside this pool, go to Pools and then select the appropriate pool. In the menu, go to Tape. To create tapes inside this pool, click the Create button. Select the pool name under which the tape should be created from the drop-down menu. Enter the number of tapes to be created. Enter the starting barcode in the specified format. Tape capacity can be left blank. The default value will be used in this case. When finished, click OK. Now, all the newly created tapes can be seen in the list. By default, the newly created tapes are inside Vault and not in the library. To import the tapes into the library, go to DD Virtual Tape Libraries, DDVTL Service, Libraries, and then the appropriate library. From the More Tasks drop-down menu, choose Tapes, and then Import. In the window to import tapes, choose the pool from the drop-down menu from which to import the tapes. Then select the tapes from the list below. For destination, from the drop-down menu, select the device where to import the selected tapes. Slot is a default device selected. In start address, enter the device number from which to start the import of tapes. Click Next and then verify the information. When satisfied, click Submit. At this point, under Pools, in the appropriate pool, verify that the location of tapes is now changed to the library slots where they have been imported. For more information about setup and upgrade processes for the DD3300, visit dell.com/support.